Thank you very much. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. May I begin with a question? Why do we go to museums? Why do we go to museums? Because we're interested in the past. We're interested in the past. Why are we interested in the past? We can learn from it. We can learn about what from it? Their mistakes. Yes, we can learn about mistakes. We can learn about their achievements. We can learn about ourselves. So the past is a very important thing, isn't it? Now, what represents the past for us in everyday life? When we're walking around a city, what represents the past and the present? Buildings. Buildings. Monuments. Yes. But buildings, because they were built in the past with by people with different ideas from ours, and they have adapted to our needs. Now, in 1975, Professor Strong in London organized an exhibition called The Destruction of the Country House. This was in response to some information he came across, which was this, that in the span of the 20th century, 2,000 major British houses had vanished. 2,000 vanished. And in order to stop this decay, he had an exhibition. A very simple one. It was simply of photographs. But the effect of the exhibition was far in excess of its cost. Because there's something about buildings that touches people. Now, my family were in their country house near Rzeszów in 1944 when a Russian armored car came up and told them they had to leave. They left. And when they arrived in London, what they kept with them was their photographic albums. Their photographic albums. Books to a lost world. Keys to a lost world. This helped them to know who they were. I myself am the son of a Polish playboy. Polish men after the war had enormous prestige in England as lovers. Great warriors, great lovers. And all I had of my father was that. Just that little photo. Throughout Poland, we have thousands and thousands of houses of all sizes, big ones, small ones, rich men's, poor men's, and they're going. Time is short. I went to see the Minister of Culture, and he gave me a cup of coffee, and he listened to the proposal that I'm about to make to you, and he said, but we have an archive full of photographs of these houses. We know where they are. And I said, what are you doing about it? How do I get to see these photographs? How does the man in the street get access to these photographs? They don't. They're locked away, safely in an archive, for posterity. Well, Minister, I'm sorry, I said, that's not good enough. We are right at the end of time for these houses. There are still people alive today who remember what they were like when they were lived in, when they were used. There's a house, a major house, in every village in Poland. And these houses represent an island of beauty, but an island of potential, because so many villages have very little going for them. There are no culture centers. There's nowhere to meet apart from the church and Radio Maria. Is that the Poland we want for the future, for our children? What we want to do is mobilize children. Get them talking with their mobile phones, their mobile video cameras, to the elderly, filming them, filming the houses, coming up with ideas of how these houses can be used for the present and for the future. But to do this, we need an archive, a living museum. This is different from Roy Strong's museum. It's not just photographs, it's videos, it's interactive. It's a web museum. Now that's where I need your help. Imagine a world without those albums that you have at home of your families, without your parents, your grandparents. and replace it with an interactive, moving museum, open to everyone, an inspiration for all. Will you help me? I'll give you a brick. Who wants a brick? First volunteer? Thank you.